Hello, sir.
Hello.
I have certain doubts in writing session of IELTS. Like when I start writing the task 2, I get confusion regarding like how to write the introductory para, what to include in the body paragraphs, and finally how to sum up the session. Using the fillers or not using the fillers, or should I use the hook lines, not hook lines, means there are lots of confusion. So this is my request to you, kindly put light on these questions so that I can write a better task too.
First of all, I want to say you thanks for having these all questions, as these would be very helpful for the people who are getting difficulties in writing task 2. Actually, writing task 2, what is it? We have to make it understand. It is not mean just a group of lines, the bundle of lines here. Actually, it is a structure. It is about your thoughts. It is about your intellect. What do you want to write down over there? I would like to tell you about all the structure, like what should you have to write down in introductory paragraph or body. And before having this session, I just want to tell you what HRC can you write. He wants to have your good response, first of all. Response means to see that what kind of facts are you writing over there, and do you have the evidence regard to that facts whichever you have wrote down over there or not. Most of the youngsters, what they used to do, they collect number of facts and they just put down the body paragraph. Second thing is about the grammar, grammatical portion. There are a lot of things which we have to take care in our mind before writing down any kind of task. It is about the tense, that is the basic thing. Sentence structure, it's a basic thing. Punctuations, we always make ignore the punctuations. Take care about the punctuations, otherwise here, what you want to see and what you want to make understand the HR, he will not be understandable according to your thoughts, whatever you want to say there. Moreover, you have to take care about your morals and the complexity. We used to write down very simple sentence structure there. It looks like a childish writing. We must have to make complex structure there, which can show your intellect and which can show your power and strength in English or in any language, not in only English, either you are writing down in Hindi or in Urdu language. If you are having the complexity of the lines, surely it will show like what kind of grip do you have over that language. Now I want to be over the introductory section. Before doing task 2, first of all, you have to take care about the statement and question. Actually, the topic which I will have been given to you, it will be divided into two portions. The first portion is statement, the second portion is question. Read the statement carefully. Sometimes what happens, there are 3 to 4 lines in the statement, and most of the times we are confused. Which one is the main statement? What is the topic actually? So do not be confused there. Just read out the statement with a cool mind, and then make it understand, and then go to the question, what things they have asked you. Just be over the question. Do not write down the extra thing than the questions, as HR will not make it, and he will not like to make it judge. He will make it underline as these all words, and those all words will be out of the topic. Clear? How to make introduction now? To make introduction, actually there are two parts. One part, like start your introduction with general fact. General fact means to say that your intellect regard to the topic. Here, we should not write down the hook lines. Many of the youngsters just cram the lines from certain books. Likewise, they write down, we are living in 21st century, we are living in modern era, this era is of science and technology. Do not write down these lines, because these are well crammed. And writing, in writing, you have to show your creativity, not the creativity of anyone else. Clear? Second thing, just go with the paraphrases. Paraphrases mean to say that the statement whichever have been given to you. Again, find out the main statement. If there are 4 to 6 lines, you have to just find out the main statement and then make it paraphrase. Then there is no need to paraphrase all the lines whichever have been given in the statement. Sometimes it happens, not every time, like 6 to 7 lines will be given in the statement. Sometimes it happens. So you have to choose the main fact over there. And that main fact should be converted into the paraphrases. And now the turn is of the question. What you have to do regarding the questions. On question, you have to give your own opinion. What do you want to do now? Okay. Again, the people here use some hook lines. Likewise, I'm agree with this statement. One segment of society say, second segment of society this one. Means they write down those all hook lines which have been given already in the books. When HR start to make it, then he make you consider, this student have learned these things somewhere else. It is not his own creativity. So please, avoid this line. Now move to the body paragraph. Before doing the body paragraph, I want to suggest you guys make some facts over the rough paper. Actually, we just start the body paragraphs at once without making any kind of plan. And as we have started, then after having third or sixth concept fact, then we think so, oh, I'm not having strongest fact over there. Then again, you make it erase. Besides doing this act, write down the effective facts over the rough paper, then make it arrange according to its number. It must be over the first number, on the second step, or on the third step. It would be easy for HR to make you understand what you want to say, and second, it would be an effective writing. What do? You write down the weakest point on the first, on the place of first fact, and then you go with the strongest point, then with the weakest point. I mean to say, it is in the disorder situation. So you have to make it in an order that, and like that, consider the structure will make HR very impressed. You have to not go only with the facts, find out the examples. There can be a formula. Write down only two facts in a one body paragraph. One fact, then explore it, then have an example there. It would be good for you as well as for the reader who is going to read it. He will make it, like for him, the matter will be totally clear. What do you want to see? You are going to write down a fact, then making it explore. And then giving, you are going to give the examples there. Examples will make and give the strength to you, to your facts, as well as the genuine kind of the writing would be out of your paper. In next paragraph, again you have to go with that same session. Write down one fact, explore it, then example. Now it is depend over the topic, which kind of topic it is. Actually, there are five kind of topics: analytical kind of topic, agree disagree, advantages disadvantages, problematic, as well as if. According to the topic, you have to maintain the paragraphs. Then after, in that conclusive paragraph, what you have to do again, do not write down the and start your conclusions with the hook lines, as most of the youngsters used to do it. I want to pin down, mean to say, this kind of line they usually use there. Do not write down this one. Just go off with the simple words. You can write down in conclusion, to conclude, to wrap up, like these simple words you have to use. Make it simple. Do not use the hook lines. And now find out the strongest points as you have written in the body paragraphs, along with your suggestions and up your conclusion point. These are questions regard to the word limit. Most of the youngsters ask me the questions, how many words I have to write down in task 2. So read carefully the instructions. Always it is written over there, at least 250 words. At least 250 word mean to see that we have to write down at least 250. There is not demand of the maximum words. You can go with 300 words, you can go with 320, 340. But you have to make it compiled in 40 minutes. And I cannot say, I will not suggest you to compile a task in 40 minutes, compile it in 30 minutes. The first 5 minutes you have to spend over the statement as well as question, and the last 5 minutes you have to read the topic again. You make many silly mistakes in the topic which can be covered by you easily. Regard to the linkers, as well as regard to the actually link, you have to link out. What is the meaning of linker? Linker means to say that make the link between two lines, and you have to make it new, make it in use. Where you look, there's a link between two lines, you have to make it in use. Okay, but it must be at a stable place. I think so. I have cleared you all the questions. If there's another question, you can ask me.
Sir, I have few questions related to the task 2.
Yeah.
How much the spelling matters in the evaluation process? Like, if I have spelling mistakes, how much I'm going to suffer because of that?
You will be suffer. Surely you will be suffer. It does not mean only your ideas are checked over. As I already told you that, there are the four things as HR will look in your writing. Okay. Your response, what you are going to write down over there with facts as well as evidences. Secondly is grammar. Third one is about your structure, and fourth vocabulary along with the spells. You have to you have to use only those spells in writing where concept words where like you know about its spelling correctly. It does not mean you just want to lure the HR by having an expensive vocabulary over there without knowing the correct spelling over there. It is also the part of the language.
Okay, sir, I have a final question. Like, is there any limit or criteria, like this much words I should use as vocabulary words, or wherever I think I can use a better word, I can? Means, is there any criteria,
no,
like 10 words of a standard there, or 15 words, or any?
No, that is the misconceptions of the youngsters, of the learners. They think, so I have to use only 10 or 20 words. I just have to cram 10 or 20 words. No, this is not the part of the real communications or real learning about a language. you must have the range of vocabulary. There's not any kind of a limit. But you have to take care about it. Most of the youngsters, what they used to do, they cram some words and they make it repeat again and again. 10 words they are having, they use 10 words more than 2 or 3 times in the writing. It is not a good effect. As HR will come to know, your grip of the on the vocabulary is in the limited way. So you have to use the range of vocabulary over there. There's no any kind of restrictions.
And one thing more, like, is it a good idea to use variety of sentence structures, or I should write the whole paragraph in one sentence type, like active sentences, or in a particular way, or should I use the variety of sentences?
Variety of sentence structure you have to use there. As I already told you, that's go with active voice, passive voice, go with the gerunds, go with the linkers, go with the complex sentences. So you have to use that all. You have to just show yourself how, like, what is about my knowledge about this language. If you are going with only one structure, it mean to say that you are very limited in that language. Mm-hmm. Go with variety of words, variety of sentence structure, it would be good for you.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you.